Yo, 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 welcome back, family. We are back. We're back again. Who are you? I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. Great. What do you do, CPA Strength? I teach the world accounting, video by video, the basics, fundamental block by fundamental block by fundamental block. What are you doing today, Mr. CPA Strength? Well, I'm doing AFB, my classic series, Accounting for Beginners 49. That's the one right before 50. Alrighty, yeah. Anyways, 49, Accounting for Beginners 49. It's a viewer's question, and it is, why is the truck an asset? Because it is an asset. And why is the truck not an expense? This is a viewer question. I've gotten this question to this point right now when I'm making this video, number 49, this board. This is the most asked question I get, which is great, because it means that a lot of people need to learn it. Like, a lot of people have this question. I love the questions because now it helps me make videos, and it helps me, and the videos I make are helping people. So you can't beat it. Anyways, you've been binging. I know you have been binge watching me, but if this happens to be like your first time, look up here. This is a link card. This is the best card in the world. Best playlist in the world. It'll make all your dreams come true. It's kind of like rubbing a genie bottle. This is what this playlist is pretty much similar to. I got here early this morning to my office, and I was just pumped because I made this board out yesterday afternoon. So I was pumped to come in here, wake up, shoot this video for number 49. And my computer wasn't working, my desktop at my office, that's got all my work stuff, although I do have a filing cabinet because I'm a paper, you know, I don't really trust computers that much. Anyways, the computer wasn't working, so that was distracting me, and I was thinking, well, I should just shoot a video, like, screw my... And then I started thinking about distractions, and that's a skill in itself to hone in. For me to do these videos the best way that I think I can, is that I have to have other not be thinking about other stuff, which is hard sometimes. So sometimes you can let those things go, or you can take care of them now. And I think, you know, growing up is however you can have that balance so you can have your mind free. Which brings me into my next thing, is that just give me 5 to 10 minutes of your time, because the lecture is starting right now, pretty much. Thank you very much. Let's go. We are going to learn, why is the truck an asset? Because I get that asked all the time. Why is the truck an asset? And then I get asked, why is the truck not an expense? Very, very summary answer is, the reason it is an asset and not an expense is the passage of time. Because here's one journal entry when you buy the truck. Look, the truck's is an asset. Asset. Cash is leaving asset. You're getting the truck an asset. So it's an asset when you buy it, but you're going to have the truck for more than 1 year. You're going to depreciate it over 5 years. So then, at the end of the year, you're going to use depreciation expense, another journal entry at the end of the year, and you're going to have depreciation expense and accumulated depreciation. So it's going to be an asset now and an expense later on. So a truck is actually both. It's actually like it's a beautiful butterfly or whatever. It was a caterpillar at first, now it's a butterfly. So that's what a truck is, you know. It's two things. It's an asset and it will be an expense. So the passage of time is This is my mapping system, DC Aid LUR, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. Debits in the positive form, credits in the positive form are going up here, normal balances. I did circle asset because that's what the truck is over here when we purchase it. And then I circled expense because the expense is the second journal entry over here, the debit to the second journal entry. This is the mapping system to keep track of everything. Let's go over here. This is our 12/31/16 balance sheet. Sorry, I had to abbreviate for space. So this is the first thing we're looking at. This is the last day of the year for 2016. What's our balance sheet looking like? Assets equal liabilities plus equity. That's our balance sheet. See, look over here. Assets equal liabilities plus equity. So this is part of DC Adler. We're going to equal and plus assets equal liability plus equity. So our balance sheet at 12/31/16 is assets equal liabilities plus 5,000 equity. The assets we have that needs to equal 5,000 is we have current assets, we have cash of $5,000. That's the only thing we have. We have cash of 5,000 and it's equity of 5,000. So 5,000 equals 5,000, last day of the year on our balance sheet. First day of the year in January 2017. What happened? We purchased a truck for $5,000 cash. This is the first order of business for the new year that you've done for your business. Bought a truck for $5,000 cash. Let's do a journal entry for that real fast. Debit, credit. What's the journal entry going to be? Do you have cash? Yes, you have cash. Purchase a truck for $5,000 cash. That means you have money leaving the business. Money leaving the business is cash as an asset. Leaving the business, so it's going to be a negative asset. So it's going to be over here. So that means it's going to be a credit. Positive asset, debit, negative asset, credit. So that means the credit for $5,000. What's going to be our debit? Well, what did you do? You bought a truck. So we're going to put a truck on a journal entry as a fixed asset, as an asset, as a fixed asset, because it's going to be fixed and we're going to depreciate it over the passage of time. So that would be our journal entry. Now you'd say, possibly, why isn't this an expense right now? You said it's going to be an expense later. Why isn't it going to be an expense right now? So anyways, this is our journal entry. Debit truck $5,000, cash $5,000. Why is it not an expense right now? Because we just spent $5,000 on a vehicle that's going to last probably 5 years. If it was going to last us 1 month, this truck was going to last us 1 month, we'd say, you know, it's going to be over and done with at the end of this period. So if it was 1 month, we'd probably put truck expense or car expense or auto expense, right? If you were renting for $500 a month or something. But now you're going to have a truck is going to be depreciated or expensed over 5 years. Because think about it, you have a truck, you spent $5,000 on a pizza delivery truck, right? So you're delivering pizzas. And you just bought it for $5,000. Now probably you're gonna have it for 5 years. If you would expense it all, meaning if you'd expense it right now, just say whatever expense, that means that it wouldn't be worth anything on the books year two, year three, in year four, and year five. So you're still using it, but then you've already expensed it all, so on your financial statements, it's showing that you have not, it's showing that you've already used it all up. When in essence, you're still using the vehicle for 4 more years. That's why you wouldn't expense it right now. And that is, in a sense, what depreciation is the expensing of an asset through the passage of time. It might be a JD Blaze original CPA strength definition, I'm not sure. Woo! Anyways, wowee. Let's keep going. So what's the balance sheet looking like after you purchased a truck for $5,000 cash? This is the journal entry. Debit truck, credit cash for $5,000. What did that do to our balance sheet? Now notice, these are just two asset accounts, so all it did was mess with our balance sheet. All it did was add to an asset and lower to an asset over here. Where did the balance sheet? Nothing to liabilities and equity. That stays the exact same as this, as the last day of the year, 12/31/16. Mind you, this is the first day of the year. I told you, January, this is the first order of business in the new year. What happened? We had $5,000 cash. We spent $5,000 cash. We have zero cash now. But we have a fixed truck in our balance sheet. That's what happened. Now, let's go to the end of the year and do depreciation expense. All right, we's back for depreciation expense. Let's go to the end of the year and do a depreciation expense. This is what happened here at the end of the year. Depreciation expense, adjusted entry for the truck. All right, now we're gonna account for the truck. Now we're gonna do the expense for the truck. First thing you do when you buy the truck, because it's gonna be used longer than 1 year, is you're gonna set up an asset. You're gonna know, okay, we're gonna use this thing in our business for multiple years, and we're gonna expense it off over the passage of time. So usually a truck will be depreciated, I believe, at 5 years. You think you bought it for $5,000, this truck. Okay, so we gotta do a depreciation, journal entry. And I just know, depreciation journal entry, debit, depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation, and then I know they're gonna equal. That's me, I'm 10 years deep. So where you're at is gonna be all different. Let's go. Now before this, why would you do it? Why are you depreciating this? Because, or, and how much, and whatever. Because we just bought a truck for $5,000. We're gonna use it for 5 years. Basically, this truck is worth $1,000 to us per year. Every year, $5,000 for 5 years, so it's really $1,000 a year. $1,000 a year we want to depreciate, we want to expense it. $1,000 a year. So in 5 years, we'll have $5,000 of expenses, and then this truck will have $5,000 of accumulated depreciation, and the truck will be depreciated to zero, and you'll have $5,000 expense in 5 years. Debit depreciation expense, $1,000, because we're going to expense this over 5 years. What's the credit to depreciation expense, accumulated depreciation for $1,000? It's an asset, it's technically a contra asset. The reason it being a contra asset is because this is what happens to the balance sheet on the last day of the year. So this is last day of the year 16, first day of the year 17. Now this is the last day of the year 17. So all we're doing, first day of the year we bought the truck, last day of the year we're depreciating the truck. I just wanted to show you, now the expense, this goes on the income statement, this from this journal entry. This accumulated depreciation is a contra asset. Contra asset meaning, let's key in on accumulated depreciation. See, the truck's still worth $5,000. When the truck's on the books, it's always going to be set up at $5,000, because that you're going to know that's what you bought it for. See, here's the balance sheet at 12/31/17. Here's accumulated depreciation. Truck's still $5,000. Accumulated depreciation, negative $1,000. Truck worth $4,000. See, that's why it's called a contra asset, because it's an asset, and it shows up with the other assets as a negative. That's accumulated depreciation. But that's the answer. Why is the number 49? Why is the truck an asset? Because you're going to use it in your business to make more money over, say, the period of a year. Why is it not an expense? Well, it is an expense of the passage of time. We are going to expense it at a later period. Till next time, squad. Deuces!